mi mai no. Oh, kava mi mai no. Oh, kava mi mai no. Hana yo shiku. Ushu. Kava mi mai no. Hey, hey, hey. Cover me, my Lord. Hey,
Oh, give him a shout of praise. Shikwembu shiniki matimba kambe banu abasiboni. Shikwembu shiniki matimba kambe banu abasiboni. Bakungulela shikwembu shanga bagusho chitaye tanchani. Bakungulela shikwembu shanga bagusho chitaye tanchani. Iburi mwana rama siku osi yeso utabuya bakahina.
Kuri mwana osi yeso utabuya.
Iburi mwana rama siku osi yeso utabuya bakahina.
Iburi mwana osi yeso utabuya.
Hina vita shimbelela yimbele. Hosanna na yeso.
Hosanna, 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 Hosanna.
Hosanna, Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna.
Hosanna,
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 my name. Favor is my name. Oh, favor is my name. Is my name. Is my favor is my name. Favor is my name. Favor is my name. Oh, favor is my name. Is my name. Is my favor is. Favor is my name. Oh. One more time. Favor is my name. What about tomorrow? Favor is my name, oh. Favor is my name. Let's go. Favor is my name. Nobody can say no.
When Jesus
says
yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
Can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
nobody can say no. When Jesus anoints you, nobody can say no. Come on. When Jesus bless you, nobody can say no. When Jesus bless you, nobody can say no. One more time. When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no. When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no. When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
Wave your hand, somebody. Just wave your hand for Jesus. Wave your hand and scream and say, hallelujah!
He has done great things. He has done great things. Hallelujah! He has done done crazy things. He has done great things. Hallelujah.
He has
done great things. Hallelujah. Yeah. He has done great. Let us adore.
Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore.
It has come to the notice of the prophet that some dubious persons are soliciting funds using social media on behalf of the prophet. Please be warned. Under no circumstance does the prophet solicit funds through his Facebook or Twitter accounts, email, or short message services to request for funds. If anybody receives any text message claiming to be the prophet requesting for funds for projects, it is fraudulent. Please be warned. Beware of fraudsters.
Because you have friends that are hard to find, we help you keep in touch. Because you have family that you love dearly, we help you share moments that you need to remember. We help share the smiles. We welcome legends into the world. We take the message there, near and far.
We bring the world much closer to you. No need to say goodbye when you can catch up later.
PSB Network, connecting and growing together.
Speak in the parables. Jesus says, this one for everyone. The whole dynamic, the whole secret, it is not in the word parable, but it is in the word behind the parable, which is the revelation of the parable, which is revealed beyond the word parable. So he speaks the parable, others understand, others not. But notice this, when the disciples come to Jesus, they never said, why do you speak to us in the parables? They said, why do you speak to them? Because according to the disciples, it's not a parable, they understand it. He said, I speak to them in the parables because they may hear it and they may understand it and they can become converted and I can heal them. So I don't want to do that. That's why the mysteries are revealed only to you. This is why you will see in your house. You sit down here, your mother's there. You're watching prophetic channel. Your mother will be like, I hate this boy. Why are you watching this guy? The same house, the daughter's like, wow, I receive. Why? It's not revealed unto them. It is revealed unto... So watch this. I don't want you to go back home just like that. If you have the parabola tonight, you must get your miracle in the name of Jesus. Because the Bible says, for you who you have the parabola, It says you shall be given even in abundance. But to them God will take away even everything they have. But for you, he shall give you in abundance. Am I talking to somebody? Jesus didn't come for everyone, but for those who shall believe in his name. About you, the Bible says you are the house of the Lord. You are the house, and Jesus came with the atonement. He shed that blood of the Lamb. Jesus, being the Lamb of God, he poured the blood which was shed on the cross, which is smeared on your body, and your body being the house of the Lord. When the enemy comes, when he sees the blood of Jesus upon your body, which is the house, he's gonna pass over. The children of Israel, none was killed. This angel of Passover was killing every firstborn son of an Egyptian. These Egyptians were torturing the Jews, but there was one day they would pay back. They would lose their children for the sake of whatever they did against the holy nation. And in this season, the angel of Passover will be dispatched. You wonder, there's no demon inside of you. You pray, you're okay, but nothing is moving in your house, because your house on its own needs deliverance. Pharaoh is a man who saw the whole country water changing into blood, but he said, I will not let you go. Last year you came in this church, you saw miracles, but Pharaoh said, I will not let you go. But there is a day, and that day is today. On the 15th of January, wait this. There were 10 plagues which were given to Pharaoh, but none of them did Pharaoh got moved of them. Apart from what happened on the 15th of January, Pharaoh resisted. All the miracles he saw, he was like, I will not let you go. But what happened on the 15th? Pharaoh said, please go in peace. I don't want to see you again. Am I talking to somebody here? Today the devil is gonna surrender. Prophet is gonna surrender. Sickness will surrender. Disease, cancer, whatever situation, it will say, please, you can go in peace. Crucified, but he took a piece of bread and gave to Judas. When Judas ate that piece of bread, the Bible says Satan entered in him. The question is, where was that Satan? I don't know how the devil entered in your life. When the devil entered this Judas, Jesus said, what you wanna do, do it quick. Who was Jesus addressing? Was he addressing Judas or the devil in Judas? My main concern here is anything that you are given as a loophole to make it as an entrance or a point of contact. The Bible says when he was cutting the tree, the axe head fell into the water, and he said, alas, for it was borrowed. But when he went to Elisha, Elisha asked a simple question, show me where it was from. There's some people the day they were touching money, the devil entered. I don't care about whatever means the devil had entered you, whether he entered through a disease, or whether through a dream, or whether through a drink, or whether through your imagination, or whether through what you have been going through or passing through. But whatever point of entry that you are in a situation which you don't understand what's happening with you and how and why, my preaching is over. The rest is removing the devil who entered in somebody. Prophetic gymnastic. Are you ready?
How's it, everybody? This is Praise Peterson here.
And I'm Dr. Praise Moxley.
And we are Double Praise Impact. We are excited to announce our first Botswana tour.
Oh yes, and we believe you'll be excited to come and praise God with us.
The first concert is going to be happening on the 28th of October at Stanbic Plaza, Molapo Crossing.
And on the 4th of November, we will be in Francistown at the Civic Center Hall.
So we are going to give away 4 special packages for 4 lucky ticket winners.
Oh yes, and this is to the International Visitors Program with our man of God, Major Prophet Shepherd Bushiri in South Africa.
Tickets are going for 150 pula, that's for the general tickets, and 500 pula for the VIP tickets.
And you can find them at Bimbo's Palapia, Pro Guard Securities, and all the malls in the country.
We are excited to come and praise and worship with you in Botswana.
So keep your eyes locked on
our social media pages
and Prophetic Channel.
Keep watching Prophetic Channel.
God is still speaking today.
Shalom.
Christians here who are praying, things are moving well in their lives, but there's a particular situation which is refusing to let them go. Prophet is holding them like this. They are working hard, trying to get a job. They can't get a job because Prophet says, I will never let you go. Oh my God, you actually come to church every day, I receive, but the demon says, I will not let you go. The Bible says, my people are suffering captives. They that held them captive are refusing to let them go. If you want to walk out of that prison, of that oppression, you must not just say, I want to walk out. No. The Bible says here, prisoners of hope, meaning to say there are 2 kinds of prisoners. There are prisoners of hope and there are prisoners of no hope. Meaning to say, we have got some people here who they believe that one day I will walk out of this situation. Those ones are having what? Hope. Now the Bible says to the prisoners of what? Hope. Not all prisoners, no. If you are here just coming and you lost hope, no, it's not for you. This message is for those who are having what? Hope. Then says, by the blood of the covenant, I shall take them out of the pit. You prisoners of hope, turn to the Lord. When you shall do so, I shall render unto you. I shall render unto you double. What the devil took from you, it shall come back. The demon that is holding you, which is refusing to let you go, it shall run away suddenly. Kaya maya.
God will locate you from nothing and make you to be something. Favor will locate the people that are most unlikely. I said the people that are most unlikely. That is favor. Let me tell you something. You know your father, he looks like a handsome young man, yeah? So yes. There was a time when we were back in Malawi. Everyone was after his case. Why? Because God is using him. And everyone was attacking him. And then I got a revelation one day.
Oh, yes.
They had written him the whole front page of a newspaper. And at that point, it's way back, we couldn't even afford to advertise ourselves the whole full page. I got the newspaper and I called him and I said, love, guess what? He said, what is it?
Oh, yes.
I said, I think God knows that we cannot manage to pay this bill. So now God has advertised you tonight and the devil is paying for it. Sometimes God needs to advertise you. And the way you are, you, for people in America to know you, it will take an advert.
Oh, yeah.
A big advert.
Oh, yeah.
And because the Lord knows you cannot pay the bill, He will advertise you, and you'll be thinking it is a negative thing. But He just wants the devil to pay the bill. Women, let me tell you, do not just be crying, hey, they are saying my husband. Hey, no, 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 no. You don't have tears for that. How will people know that your husband exists? You need to know that this is God advertising us.
The holy prophetess,
my
the
God,
the mother of the house.
When the Holy Spirit is inside of you, it is another type of the dimension. When the Spirit of God is in a man, so there's the Holy Spirit in a man. Now the Bible says when He is in you, it's not for ministry. I have seen so many people who want to preach and to lay the hands on the sick and pray for people because they feel they have the Holy Ghost inside of them, which is wrong. When the Holy Spirit is inside of you, it is for conviction, to convict the world of sin, the world of judgment, and the world of righteousness. So when the Holy Ghost is inside of you, it is just for you to walk in God's ways. But there is another level now that God takes the Spirit and make Him be with you. Now when He is with you, it's not a level of you to walk in the righteousness. It is a level of revelation. The Bible says, He shall speak unto you all things, even the things to come. When He is in, is for you to walk in righteousness. When He is with, is for you to have revelations, prophecy, visions, and all these things. When He is on, is for you to cause changes. To be filled with the Holy Spirit is not to just to say, I have the Holy Spirit. It means every time you pray, just a little bit, it's like it goes on top of you. An overflow affecting things around you. You may agree with me. Every person who is having the Holy Ghost may agree with me. Every time you are praying, you see yourself a great person. You see yourself driving nice cars. You see, those are the things that God gave you. They are in the Spirit. But for them to be in the physical, you need now outpouring of the Spirit to have the Holy Ghost and be broken. It doesn't make sense. To make it to heaven is easy. We know that we are going there. Me, I know, and I know you're going there. But our problem is not going there. Our problem is going there poor. Wisdom, it is a type and a kind of wisdom which is a natural wisdom, streetwise wisdom, which you acquire in a way that you are able to escape from trouble yourself. Where can we find the Hokima? If we are in trouble or problem, we must be knowing how to move out of the trouble. It's a type and a kind of wisdom whereby if you are in a particular situation or trouble, you are able to escape. This is the wisdom which the Bible says the prudent man or the righteous man sees trouble and run away. But the foolish man sees trouble and stays there. What man makes you, it gives you ability to sense danger. And you need a Hokima where when a danger comes or a trouble comes or a problem comes, you know how to escape from it. The scripture here tells you that someone or some people who are looking for this wisdom, now they go to the land says, it's not with me. They go to the sea says, it's not with me. The depth under the earth says, it's not with me. So where is it? God knows where you can find this wisdom. Even the demons can't find it. Even devil is saying what? I don't know it. I've just heard the term. there is something called the Hokima wisdom, which when a person has it, is able to escape from us. And today I've come to announce of your liberty and of your deliverance. Future of South Africa. God has located your country. God has raised the flag in your nation. The nation of South Africa shall be a nation ordained and blessed by the living God in the name of Jesus. Nations shall see God in South Africa. There shall be peace in the name of Jesus. There shall be unity and oneness in the name of Jesus. We pray for unity. We pray for oneness. We pray for togetherness in the name of Jesus.
In our world where everyone is looking for answers and our world can spiral out of control, everyone needs a word of edification, a word of encouragement, a voice of authority, a voice of victory. Anyone who receives a prophet shall receive a prophet's reward. The blessings that awaits those whose hearts are open to manifestation baffles the lost world, but it gives joy to those who can discern the presence of a man of God. A man of God who carries the presence of God brings with him blessings, deliverance, healing, insights, and the words of knowledge.
I see aeroplanes flying to South Africa to serve God, to worship God in South Africa. I prophesy the prophetic movement in the nation in the name of Jesus. There shall be revival in the name of Jesus. South Africa, in the name of Jesus. May the Lord remember you in this nation. May you never fail in this nation. May you make it in the name of Jesus. As long as you live in this nation, you shall never struggle again. I deliver you and the nation in the name of Jesus. Prophets can deliver a nation. I say prophets can deliver a nation. I deliver the nation in the name of Jesus. I remove financial constraints in Jesus' name. You are blessed in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
oh God. We declare that your name, we raise our voice,
raise our voice to you, O Lord.
Power.
Power.
That's our power.
Power.
Our God.
Can you clap your hands for King Jesus? Can you make a loud noise to Jesus? Can you shout and tell him that you love him? I need someone to wave your right hand, wave both your hands and say, Jesus, I am head over heels in love with you. Come on, say it like you mean it. Say, Son of God, I love you. Say, Holy Ghost, I adore you. Say, Abba, Father, I love you so much. Now, can you just raise your right hand? Father, these are your people. These are the sons and the daughters of your major prophet. I pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the precious, mighty name of the Lord Jesus, let tonight be a special night under the grace of our Father. Let devils and demons bow the knee to the name of Jesus tonight. Let sickness flee at the mention of the name of Jesus Christ. Let somebody receive hope tonight, Lord. Let a dead ministry be revived tonight. Let someone's marriage be restored tonight, Lord. Breathe life into somebody's body tonight. And all God's people said amen.
Amen.
Can you shout a prophetic amen?
Amen.
Turn to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, is that a new hairstyle? Say, this one suits you better, neighbor. Amen. If you can make a loud noise just to show that you are alive and breathing. Hallelujah. I am so excited to be in the house of God tonight under this prophetic grace, under this open heaven. There's one thing that I've learned about the ministration of Major One. Wherever Major One goes, the heaven is open. I'm telling you, wherever my Father goes, the heavens just, you see, the heavens just open up now. Wherever Major One sets his foot, the heavens open. If Major One prays a prayer, the heavens are rent open. Amen. And it is amazing. People can pray for so many years and no answers come. Until my Father sets foot in the same place and he declares open heavens and he prays for spiritual rain to come, people begin to testify. Amen. Just like you are about to testify tonight. Hallelujah. Come on, make a noise. Clap your hands for Jesus. Before we get into some things, I'm telling you, this pulpit is red hot tonight. This pulpit, I can see smoke coming from the pulpit. I see fire coming from the pulpit. Hallelujah. Something is about to happen tonight. Amen. There are flames that are about to jump out of this pulpit into your own life. Amen. Into your spirit. Into your ministry. Hallelujah. Before we get into some things, I want to honor and appreciate the grace of our Father, Major One, the greatest prophet of our generation. Amen. And I believe Major One is one of the end time prophets. I'm telling you, you don't prophesy deeper than Major One. There's no level beyond the level of Major One. Amen. When it comes to teachings, you don't teach deeper things than Major One. Amen. These are end time teachings. This is the end time anointing that will usher us right into the presence of God. Amen. I'm telling you, this is the last bus stop. From here, we are all going to heaven. Hallelujah. You're not even excited to go to heaven. The other day, I was on social media and they're talking about meteorites and everything that's going to hit the earth and destroy a third of the human race and whatever. And people are so afraid, they are making plans where they're going to go, where they're going to run. I said, me run away? I said, no. When the first meteorite comes, I'll be running outside. That first one must hit me right between the eyes. I'm going home. Hallelujah. I'm going to Jesus. Why do you want to hang around here if Jesus is calling us home? Amen. Clap your hands for Jesus. Just shake the hand of your neighbor next to you and you may have your seat in this precious anointing. Be careful where you sit now, because that chair where you are sitting is carrying a miracle. Amen. Amen. Be very careful where you sit tonight. You might just sit on the chair that is marked for a prophecy tonight. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Ask your neighbor. Say, neighbor, are you a soul winner? He took too long to answer, right? He's a suspect. Ask the other one. Are you a soul winner? Ask him, how many souls have you won this past week? If he takes too long to answer, he's a suspect. Can you just wave your Bible? I want to see if you have your Bible with you. The Bible says the Word of God is the sword of the Spirit. And the sword of the Spirit is a nice big Bible. Amen. If you have one of those small pocket Bibles, that one is not a sword, it's just an okapi. You need to have the sword of the Spirit. Have yourself a proper Bible. Intimidate the devil. Amen. You can't intimidate the devil with your small Bible. Hallelujah. And you have to bring it real close to your eyes to read. You can't even see. Jesus. Come on, kiss your Bible. Say, Lord Jesus, I love this book. Kiss your Bible. Come on. Hallelujah. I want to get into some things tonight before the prophetic anointing strikes this place and changes the lives of so many people tonight. Amen. Somebody say amen. There's a level in God that we cannot discover if we stand alone. There's a level in God, and there are deep hidden secrets in God that you and I can never discover on our own. For the simple reason that we are not all the same, and we are not called for big things. Amen. I know in your own right, God has a special calling on your life, a special plan for your life. But there's something that differentiates us from prophets. Amen. God has called prophets, and He has chosen to reveal Himself through prophets and to reveal Himself to prophets. Amen. And we learn that through history, through Bible history, when we see how they came through the desert and whatever God wanted to show the people, He showed it through His prophet Moses. Can you say Moses? So when God wanted to prove that I can provide to the people, He said, Moses, let quails come. And quails came. When He wanted to prove to His people that He can make a way, He said, Moses, just raise your hand, and the waters parted. And every attribute of God that He wanted to show to the people, He did it through a prophet. Amen. Because His whole character can flow through a prophet. Why? Because God has chosen to reveal Himself to prophets. Amen. Prophets know much more about God than you and I do. The Bible says they meet with God face to face. You and I, we read scriptures, then we scratch our head. We wonder what the scripture means. But my Father, when He reads the Bible, it is as if He is in a one-on-one conversation with God Himself. Amen. You know, when people come from all over the world to meet with Major One, we call it a one-on-one. Amen. My Father has a one-on-one with God Himself every day of His life. Amen. There's no scripture in the Bible that He cannot interpret for us and to us. Can you say amen? Amen? Now, I found a beautiful story in the Old Testament in the book of Kings. I want to read this to you. In 2 Kings chapter number 4, if you want to page there quickly. 2 Kings chapter number 4. This is a story of a woman. This woman was so wise. She understood that she also loved God. She said, I love Jehovah, the God of Israel, but I understand there's a man of God that knows more, that has more access to God, that has the ability to hear the voice of God. And she said, if I'm going to connect to God, I'd better find myself under this man of God. And we pick up the story in 2 Kings chapter number 4 and verse 8. Allow me to read just a couple of verses. Are you still here tonight? Are you still happy to be here tonight? Say, neighbor, your chair is carrying a miracle tonight. Yes. 2 Kings chapter 4 and verse 8. The Bible says, now it happened one day that Elisha went to Shunem, where there was a notable woman, and she persuaded him to eat some food. So it was, as often as he passed by, he would turn in there to eat some food. And she said to her husband, look, look now, I know that this is a holy man of God who passes by us regularly. Please let us make a small upper room on the wall, and let us put a bed for him there, and a table, and a chair, and a lampstand. So it will be, whenever he comes to us, he can turn in there. Verse 11. And it happened one day that he came there, and he turned into the upper room and lay down there. Then he said to Gehazi, his servant, call the Shunammite woman. When he had called her, she stood before him. And he said to her, say now to her, he said to him, say now to her, look, you've been concerned for us with all this care. What can I do for you? Amen. You may close your Bible. This woman loved the God of Israel. She had heard all the stories. She feared this God and she loved him at the same time. She wanted to know more about God. And God favored her that this man of God would come pass her way ever so often. And he would stop by to eat something. And she saw the benefit of that, eating with a prophet. Until one day she said, no, I want another level. I am going to add a room on the top of my own house. And I want the man of God, whenever he comes here, he can just go upstairs and sleep there and rest there and just commune with God, communicate with God, do whatever he does. Amen. But he must be on top of my house. Meaning, he must be between heaven and myself. Can you say amen? Amen. Why? This woman understands there's a level in God that she would never see if she doesn't see it through the eyes of a prophet. Amen. She understood there are prayers that she can pray that she could never pray if she doesn't pray it with the understanding that this is the God of a major prophet. Amen. She knew if she could connect with this God, and this was the way for her to connect, to put the man of God above herself. Amen. To put the man of God above herself, between her and heaven. Amen. When the man of God is above you, it means that you are under the man of God. Amen. It means that you are submissive to the man of God. It is only when you are submissive to the man of God that the God of the man can flow into your life. Amen. You don't hear too many testimonies of people out there when they say, oh, I prayed to the God of Major One and things happened. But you hear many testimonies when people say, I'm a son of Major One and I'm a daughter of Major One and I submit to the same grace, and that grace now flowed into my life. Can you clap your hands for Jesus? There's something about submission. There's something about realizing that you don't have the access to God that the man of God has. Amen. There's something about realizing that a prophet has more access to God than you have. You say evangelist, but the Bible says we are seated in heavenly places. Let me ask you a question. Why then don't you have testimonies, my sister? Why is it, my brother, you don't have testimonies? Why is it you only started testifying since you connected and submitted under the man of God? There's a secret here. There is power to submission. Can you say amen? Oh, evangelist, as for me, I submit to the prophet, but I refuse to submit to the leaders in the church. You are not submitting to the prophet. It is the same prophet that you are talking about that appointed those leaders. Amen. Do you think if Elijah can send Gehazi and say, tell the woman to do that, and they refuse Gehazi, do you think the blessing will flow? No. Submission goes through leadership, and grace and favor flows through leadership. Can you say glory to Jesus? Can we go to the next gear now that we've laid a foundation? Oh, I'm telling you, I sense the prophetic grace in this place tonight. I sense the grace of my Father Major One present here tonight. Did you know that wild animals, when a deer is pregnant, do you know that wild dogs out there, they can sense it and they can smell it? Especially when this animal comes closer to the time when she must now deliver. There are wild dogs and wild animals out there, they know this is time for delivery. They know this is time this animal is about to bring forth her miracle, to bring forth her baby. And these wild packs and packs of wild dogs, they start following these animals. And they see the animal is growing bigger and bigger. And they see the animal is traveling slower and slower because the animal is about to give birth. Can you say Jesus? So all these wild animals, like wild dogs, they home in on this one animal because they know there is no better food than a newborn baby. There is no better meat out there in the wild than a freshly born deer. Amen. So they just follow it. They're not even stressed. They know somewhere this thing is about to give birth. Can you say amen? And when that thing gives birth, they are ready there to consume it. Can you say hallelujah? And this is where we see how the devil operates. The devil has been watching some of us. They are monitoring spirits. They've been watching you. They've been seeing you with that miracle in you. They've been seeing you ready to give birth to your miracle. And now they are following you. Amen. And they are not concerned about your life. They are concerned about the baby that you are going to bring forth. Amen. Because that one is easy prey. When you start a new ministry, it is easy prey for the devil. When you are just married, it is easy prey for the devil. You ask any freshly married couple, the first 1 or 2 or 3 years of your marriage, ask them, has it been easy? They will all tell you it's not been easy, my brother. They will tell you it's been hell. We had to hang in there. Why? It's because now you gave birth to that miracle. And the wild spiritual wild dogs, they are there to consume that thing. Amen. The only thing that can save you is when you stand under a greater grace. Hallelujah. A grace that is ever awake. A grace that is at its zenith all the time. A grace that speaks for you when you are weak and you cannot speak for yourself. Amen. There was an ad on national television some time ago. It was an ad on SPCA, where, you know, SPCA, they love to take care of stray animals and injured animals. And the ad goes like this. It's a story told by a father. He says he used to travel by car to his workplace. And he says every day as he traveled, the one day he saw a dog lying at the side of the road. And this dog was dead. He said the following day he passed the same dog and the dog was dead. He said by the third day he passed the same dog and the dog was dead. But as he passed the dog, something just told him, just look in your rear view mirror. And the moment he looked in his rear view mirror, he saw the dog behind him just raising his head just a little bit. Just a little bit. And the man slammed on the brakes and he reversed his car. He went back and he checked the dog. The dog was still alive. And the man picked up the dog and he rushed him to the SPCA and they nursed the dog back to health. Can you say thank you, Jesus? Your own situation. You've been looking at your own life and people have been looking at your situation and they passed you by. They said, this situation is dead. And the following year came again and people looked at your ministry again. They said, this ministry is dead. There's nothing happening there. And the third year, people came looking at you again. They said, there's nothing happening in that business. That business is no threat to us. There's nothing happening. The business is dead. And as Major One was traveling, Major One raised his head and he looked in the rear view mirror. And he saw your business just raising the head a little bit. He saw your marriage raising the head a little bit. He saw your ministry. He saw there was still a faint heartbeat. And Major One slammed on the brakes. He said, no, there's still some life in him. Let us go and revive that one. Hallelujah. And when Major One came, he nursed you back to life. Can you say, thank you, my Jesus? Do you know many of you sitting here holding hands with your lovey tonight? Do you know if not for this grace, your marriage could have failed last year? Do you know that same business that's putting money on your, that's putting food on your table even today, that business could have failed last year if not for the grace of a major prophet? Amen. You were saved by grace, my sister. Don't sit there so high and holy and say, I prayed for my own salvation. No, it is the grace that God sent us that saved you. Amen. Some of us, we should have been dead. Some of us, we should have been buried 6 feet under. But thank God for the grace that saved us. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, this past weekend must have been one of the best services I've ever had in my life. It was undiluted heaven in this place. Hallelujah. It was healing upon healing upon healing. Healings pop just like popcorn. I'll never forget, I was downstairs with Major One. He was praying for this one lady in the wheelchair. Oh, that man with the cancer in the my goodness. And Major One was saying, this man will talk now. And I'm saying, Lord Jesus, don't let my father be embarrassed today. But I forgot he was a major prophet. Hallelujah. May that same grace came upon you today. May that same grace change your story today. I'm telling you, whatever seemed to be dead is coming back to life in the name of Jesus. Tell your neighbor, after tonight you are surely testifying. Not that neighbor, the other one. Can you tell your real neighbor? The Bible says Christians are the light and Christians are the salt of the earth. Do you know salt? Nobody takes notice of salt until there's no salt. It is only in the absence of salt that people appreciate salt. You sit at a table and you begin to eat, and there's no salt, soon you will ask, where's the salt? Can I have some seasoning, please? But if there's seasoning on the food, nobody says nothing. Nobody says, this salt is very nice. Nobody says that. I'm telling you, you start removing Christians from workplaces and you will see what will happen to businesses. You start removing yourself from that workplace and you will see what's going to happen to that business. They will miss you, my sister. They will miss you, my brother. Amen. I speak to everyone that God laid off. They will call you back in the name of Jesus. Everybody that got retrenched, they will call you back because they miss your presence. Hallelujah. Do you know, in the days before Major One in South Africa, nobody missed Major One because we didn't know there's such a thing as Major One. We didn't even know there was such a thing as the grace of a major prophet. Amen. But now that we've grown to love this grace so much, now that we are dependent on this grace so much, when you remove this grace, I am telling you, we will miss this grace. Hallelujah. When you remove the salt, we're going to miss the salt. Amen. May God never remove Major One from Pretoria. May God never move our father from this continent. Amen. Some people are quiet. It's like you are praying for Major One to come to your country, right? I don't trust you. You are suspect. Matthew chapter number 15, quickly. Matthew chapter number 15. Somebody say, Ramaso koto paladese. E ramando so kelemandes. I can't seem to find Matthew. Is it in the Old Testament? Somebody said yes. Matthew chapter number 15, and I'm reading from verse 21. Are you there? I just sat these past days and I was reading this account in the Bible again, and I'm telling you, it means so much to me, and my prayer is that God will give you enlightened eyes of understanding tonight, that the scripture will change your life. Amen. May the scriptures help us to go to the next level. Hallelujah. Major One announced that this weekend is a weekend of dealing with the spirit of staying too long. Amen. The spirit of overstaying. there's a place in your life that you have grown accustomed to. Amen. And you thought that was your happy place. But God is saying there's a better place. It's time for you to pack your bags and move on to the better place. Amen. But some of us, we don't even know there's a better place. Evangelist Fritz is here to tell you tonight, there's a better place waiting for you. Glory to Jesus. There is a higher spiritual level waiting for you. Amen. There's more money waiting for you to come and grab it. Glory to Jesus. If you're already married, there's no better husband waiting for you. Amen. If you already have a wife, don't say now there's a better wife. No, that is the one God gave you. Amen. Clap your hands for Jesus. I know some people, they're just looking for an excuse to dump the old wife and to find a new one. At ECG, we don't do that. Amen. You marry one for life. Hallelujah. Jesus. Some of you, I don't trust you. If you are watching us from, if you are watching us on prophetic channel, clap your hands for Jesus. Say, thank God for my wife, thank God for my husband. Some people do that, you know, when they have a car, they drive a car just until they are tired of the dashboard. They say, this dashboard now, it irritates me, I'll trade it in and get a new one. Some people, they do that with the wives. They look at the dashboard, they say, no, I'm tired of this one. No, we don't do that. ECG, sons of Major One, you marry once and you stay with that woman. Amen. Even you ladies, when you are married, don't be looking around. There's no better one out there. That is the best one for you. I don't know how we got to that topic now, but let's go back to Matthew 15. Matthew chapter number 15. Allow me to read. Then Jesus went out from there and departed to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Canaan came from that region and cried out to him, saying, "Have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David. My daughter is severely demon-possessed." But he answered her not a word. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she cries out after us." But he answered and said, "I was not sent except to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." Then she came and worshipped him, saying, "Lord, help me." But he answered and said, "It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the little dogs." And she said, "Yes, Lord. Yet even the little dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered and said to her, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be to you as you desire." Can you clap your hands for Jesus? We read about this woman, and I learned so much from this dear woman. She was not a Jew. She was a Gentile. And she came and she said, she prayed to the master. She prayed to Jesus. She said, "My children is severely demon possessed." The Bible says Jesus answered her not. And I know many of you sitting here tonight, you prayed so many prayers to God without any answer. Not even a word. God completely ignored you. And you prayed again, you got ignored again. You prayed some more, you fasted, and you got ignored again. Can you say, "That's me, evangelist"? And many times he ignored you. And the disciples came to Jesus. They said, "Can you tell her to go her way? Because she is bugging us." Jesus said, "Look, I am not called to those people. I'm called to the lost sheep of Israel." And again the woman came. The Bible says this time now she worshipped him. And Jesus says, "Look, woman, it's not good to take the bread that is meant for the children of God and to give it to dogs." He likened this woman to a dog because she was a Gentile. First, she prayed. She got ignored. Second time, she made a request and there was a negative answer. You prayed so many prayers and many times you were ignored. And then you prayed again because you were persistent. But God said, no, I'm not giving you this thing. And the third time you prayed and you came with your argument before God, you said, Lord, I know I don't qualify. Just like this woman. She said, I know I don't qualify. I'm not even arguing. But at least the bread you are feeding these people, let the crumbs fall from the table and the dogs can eat the crumbs. And when she said this, now what Jesus saw is humility. What Jesus saw was desperation. And Jesus could no longer give her a negative answer. He could no longer ignore this woman. And Jesus was amazed. He said, woman, you have such great faith. Let whatever you ask be done unto you. Can you say amen? Amen. You've prayed many prayers. God, give me that business. God, help me to get married. God, let me start my own ministry. And God has been quiet on you. And then you prayed some more and someone came to you and say, you prayed for this thing, but God says, no, this is not the time. And you prayed some more. You said, Lord, I'm getting older and older. And the Lord said, no, these things are not for you. These things are for fluent, educated people and this, that, and the other. And you are disqualified. But because of persistence, you came once again. Can you say amen? Amen. Some of you came to ECG and you prayed to the God of Major One. And the first month you never got an answer. He ignored you. Amen. And the second month he ignored you. And year one he ignored you. Year two he ignored you. But by year three now you are saying, God, I know I don't qualify. I know I don't have a right. But I come and I say, I am a daughter and I am a son of your major prophet. Let the crumbs fall from the table for me tonight. Amen. You don't even need a whole loaf of bread from heaven. All you need is some crumbs tonight. Hallelujah. All you need is a little bite. Can you say amen? Amen. God has abundant supply. The question is, can you make a demand tonight? The question is, can you make a demand? Can you say, God, I know you ignored me. I know you said no and no and no a couple of times, but I'm here yet once again and I'm going to make a noise in heaven until you grant my request. Amen. There are some things that are not given to everybody. They are only given to persistent people. There are some healings that are reserved for persistent people. Some miracles reserved for people that don't take no for an answer. You come here, you say, I know I don't qualify. I know you've given that one a miracle, you've given that one a miracle, but I'm not going to stop until I hold my miracle in my hand. Can you say amen? Amen? The greatest problem today is stagnation. When you are stagnant, I'm telling you, your prayers don't go anywhere. When you are stagnant, you begin to doubt yourself. You begin to doubt the calling God has on your life. You begin to doubt even the man of God. Because your business has been on the same level for so many years. Stagnancy. God hates stagnancy. God does not want you to stay in the same place for too long. Amen. He has made us with that ability to progress ever so often. Amen. Every day progress a little bit. Progress a little bit. Can you say glory to Jesus? In India, they have a certain snake. It is some sort of a cobra snake. This thing is dangerous. But people play with a snake. They stand in long grass, right? They stand in long grass. The man stands over here and he whistles. Don't try this at home, right? The man stands over here and he whistles. And the snake stands up on its tail on that side. Until the head can see over the grass. Just to see where the man is whistling from. Once the head goes down, The man that's standing here to whistle, he must move now. Because in 1 minute's time, the snake is going to appear here. You whistle and you see, okay, there's the snake. Now you move, you go elsewhere. After 1 minute, the snake will appear there, but the snake will find you over here again. Can you say amen? Amen. Now the snake is frustrated. It lifts its head again. It knows that was the position where you were at. But where are you now? It lifts the head again. Can you say amen? But now you have moved your position. Now you whistle from here again. When the head goes down, you move again. You go this side. After 1 minute, the snake pops out here. Why? It knows your position. You stay in one position too long, that snake is coming for you, my sister. You stay in one place too long, the snake is coming to bite you. Amen. But I'm telling you, if you can play with a snake like this, you whistle here, you move there. You whistle there, you move there. Sooner than later, you're going to make that snake so tired and you can attack that thing and kill it. Amen. You come with a snake against it and you beat it all over the head. Amen. You say, you snake, my wisdom is greater than your wisdom because I tap wisdom from above. Amen. God spoke to Major One. He said, this weekend, deal with that spirit of overstaying in one place. It's dangerous. Staying in one place, very dangerous, my friends. Your church, you've had 25 members for 4 years. Very dangerous. The snake is coming for you. Your business, it's been on the same level for so long. And the devil knows that you've taken that money and bringing it to church. The devil is coming for that business. It's time to move to another dimension. Amen. It's time to move your position. Shift a little bit in the realm of the spirit. Amen. The devil does not understand when you move in the spirit. That's why Paul continuously says, he says you must walk in the spirit. Over and over, Paul writes in the Bible, walk in the Spirit. Why? The devil cannot monitor you when you walk in the Spirit. If you make a noise for Jesus in a certain town, and your church remains on the same level, spiritually, you don't grow, you don't progress. You just make a noise for Jesus. You sing songs and you tell some people about Jesus, and Sunday you just have church again. The devil is saying, oh, that man is staying on the same level spiritually. I'm coming for him. But when the devil comes for you because you've been making a noise, when he gets there, he should find you on another level already. Amen. In a different position already. Amen. Can you stand to your feet quickly in the presence of Jesus? Say, Lord Jesus, I am not staying here any longer. I want to move to another dimension spiritually. Come on, clap your hands for Jesus. Oh, glory to Jesus. There is life. There is life in the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus can point in your direction once and life flows into your life. Jesus can speak one word and life flows. Amen. Can you say amen? Amen? Before we get into some deeper things, I want to make sure that everybody in this place is right with God. I want to make sure that those watching us on Prophetic Channel, that you are right with God. This is the purpose of my life. This is why I was brought forth. Amen? This is why my mother gave birth to me, is just to win souls. Hallelujah. And I thank God that I could connect with the grace of my Father, Major One. Because of this grace, because of this ministry, my Father, many souls have come into the kingdom. Can you clap your hands for Jesus? I love Major One for many reasons, but I'm telling you probably the main reason I love Major One so much is because he has a heart for souls. It's because Major One throws so much resources into soul winning. He spends so much time, he spends so much money just for soul winning. Just for that, can you appreciate the grace of Major One? There are ministries out there, when the money starts flowing, they buy big houses and cars and everything. I'm telling you, when money started flowing to Major One, the first thing Major One did was to fund people to go and win souls. Amen. It's the first thing he did. He started paying salaries to people. Said, you just go and win souls. Go and preach to people in the streets. Amen. And he funded so many ministries because of soul winning. Hallelujah. I appreciate. That is why I love my Father so much. Hallelujah. So maybe you have just tuned in and maybe you're just scrolling through the channels on your television set, and God led you to prophetic channel because you saw a funny white man there with a microphone. Allow me to preach the gospel to you in 2 minutes. The Bible says in the book of Colossians that once you were alienated from God, it means that when God made us and when He sent us to earth, we were connected to Him. But because of sin, we were alienated. We were separated. Oh, I had a friend. And this friend of mine, he was a quite rough around the edges. Amen? He was like some of you used to be. The man used to go to the beer holes. He used to go to all these places where you hear doof, doof, doof music. And the man liked to drink. He loved his puza. And so one night, or shall I say in the morning hours, this thing actually happened. It's a true story. They were on their way from the beer hole, drunk, himself and his friend. And on the way home, they played with each other. And the one was bumping the other one, and the other one was kicking the other one. But they were playing. But in the process, they passed the building, and there was a security guard guarding this building. And this security guard didn't understand what was happening. He thought the two people were fighting. And the security guard approached the one man. He said, "No, stop kicking him." The guy said, "Hey, who are you?" He said, "Don't come closer." The man had a shotgun with him. He said, "Don't come close." The security guard said, "Don't come closer. I will shoot you." And the man came closer because he was drunk. The security guard pulled the trigger of the shotgun. He took his right leg off. One shot. Separated his right leg completely. The man fell here. His leg fell that side. True story. The ambulance came. The ambulance picked the man up, put him in the back of the van. And he said, "No, please bring my leg." They put his leg on the other bed next to him. They took him to hospital. They put him in the hospital bed and the doctor came. The doctor said, "You know what? Let us try something. Let us see if we cannot save this man's leg." They brought a bucket of ice. They put his leg on ice right next to him. And they put a plastic tube into the leg. Are you following? A plastic tube into the leg, and the plastic tube came into his leg where it was severed. Just to feed the leg with blood. And they circulated the blood through this dead leg until they waited for the surgeon to come and see what he can do. A couple of weeks later, they stitched his leg back together. And I'm telling you, I met a man after the operation. He walked like you and me naturally. You wouldn't say. You would not say he even had an operation. You would never say the man lost his leg. What saved his leg? Blood flowing from the body kept the leg alive until the surgeons came and they stitched him back up. It took him months of rehabilitation, but at least they joined the leg back together with the body. Can you say thank you, Jesus? Now the scripture I gave you said, we were once alienated from God. We were separated from God. Amen. But now God is saying, I'm willing to give you a lifeline. The blood of Jesus Christ. If the blood of Jesus can flow through you, then we can get you and stitch you into the body of God again. Amen. So that you become one with God. That you become part with God again. You have a choice tonight. You can say, leave me outside. I want to die by myself and on my own. Or you can say, let the blood of Christ flow through my veins. Let the blood of Jesus wash away my sins. Bring me alive together with Christ again. The blood of Jesus gives you life. It is written in the book of Leviticus. It says the life is in the blood. If you are alive without Jesus, you are just a walking corpse. You're not really alive. You just exist. It's like an animal. Animals, they just exist. If you are without Jesus, there's no difference between you and an animal. But God made us different. Amen. He gave us the ability to contain God. He gave us the desire toward God. Amen. The only thing that you need to do is to say, Lord, I have sinned against you. Can you forgive me? Can you wash me with your blood? Just say, Lord, I repent tonight. I'm willing to turn my back on sin. I want you to stitch me up with the body of Christ again so that life can flow into me. If that's you tonight, I am about to pray the sinner's prayer to ask God to wash you with his blood. Let the blood of Christ flow into your life and bring fresh life. If that's you tonight, you say, evangelist, please include me in your prayer. Just slip up your hand and wave. Let me see. Slip up your hand and wave. Come on. Can you slip it up properly and wave? Even those watching on prophetic channel, just keep your hand up. Keep your hand up. Those watching on prophetic channel, you say tonight, I want to receive Jesus. I want the blood of Jesus to flow through me so that I can be alive again. Just be kneeling in front of your television set and follow me as I pray together. Can you pray with me? Say, God of the heavens.
God of the heavens.
Can you be serious when you pray? Say, God of the heavens.
God of the heavens.
Say, God of the Bible.
God of the Bible.
God of Major One.
God of Major One.
Say, Lord, I have sinned against you.
Lord, I have sinned against you.
I have offended you.
I have offended
Say,
you.
Say, oh God, I broke your laws.
Oh God, I broke your laws.
Tonight I repent of my sins.
Tonight I repent of my
Say,
sins.
Say, Father, please forgive me.
Father, please forgive
Say,
me.
Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
There's life in your blood.
There's life in your
There's
blood.
There's forgiveness in your blood.
There is forgiveness in your blood.
Say, wash away my sins, Lord.
Wash away my
wash
sins.
Wash me with your blood, Jesus.
Wash me with your blood, Jesus.
Let your blood flow into my life.
Let your blood flow into my life.
And bring life where there's death in me.
Bring life where there's death in
Say,
me.
Say, Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Fill me.
Fill me.
Fill me.
Fill me.
Fill me, Holy Spirit.
Fill me, Holy Spirit.
Say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I am born again.
I'm born again.
I am saved and sanctified.
I'm saved and sanctified.
Come on, can you appreciate Jesus?
Yeah!
Let your living waters flow by my soul. Let your Holy Spirit come and take control in every situation that has troubled, oh Lord, my mind. All my curses and burdens unto you unto you. Holy Spirit. We cry out, Holy Spirit. The church sing out, Spirit, Spirit, we call you Spirit.
It's time.
clap your hands for Jesus. Clap your hands for King Jesus. Somebody's life is about to change tonight. Somebody is about to come with a testimony after tonight. Somebody is about to receive a prophecy tonight. Hallelujah. I told you that sometimes we start off slow, but then we go to a next gear, we go to the next level, amen. And tonight we have the man of God, our very own Apostle Magawa, to take us to the next gear, hallelujah. Hey, come on, somebody say racing gear tonight. Are you ready for a revival tonight? Help me. Help me welcome to the pulpit the son of Major One, the associate of our father, our very own Apostle Magawa. Somebody say Manasseh.
Let us raise our hands. Glory be to God. Once again, we are here to thank God for the grace that is upon our Father, Major One. I'm telling you, our lives have changed because of the grace that is upon our Father, Major One. That's why we are here to thank God for the grace that is upon him. And tonight I believe, because of the grace that is upon him, our lives will no longer be the same. Just because you are connected to the grace upon his life, Major One, the major prophet in the house, I believe your story will change. Let us just thank God. Open our mouth and thank God for the grace that is upon Major One. We thank you, Lord, for the grace that is upon your servant. Our lives have changed because of the grace that is upon him. I pray tonight that, Lord, as we are connected to the grace that is upon him, our lives will no longer be the same. The sick will get healed tonight. The lame will walk. The blind will see. I declare by faith, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, those who want promotion, they'll receive that promotion tonight. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Tell three people, it is well, it is well. Tell three people, it is well, it is well, it is well. Hoti, are we there? Hoti, 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 hoti. I believe your life will no longer be the same. Let us have a seat. Glory be to God. First Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 13. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah. First Thessalonians chapter 2 from verse 13. For this reason, we also thank God without ceasing, because when you received the word of God, which you heard from us, you welcomed it not as the word of man, but as it is in truth, the word of God, which also effectively works in you who believe.
Glory be to God. Let us solve it together. 1, 2, 3, go. Amen. This is Apostle Paul speaking. He said, we also thank God continually, because when you receive the word of God, which he heard from us, you accepted it not as human word, but it is actually the word of God, which is indeed at work in you who believe. Apostle Paul said, I thank God. Because the time we are preaching to you, you receive the word as it God is speaking to you, not Apostle Paul speaking to you. Am I communicating? And also you said, the word you received, the word you heard, there are two words there. To hear the word of God is something. To receive the word of God is something. Am I communicating? And the Bible says, the word of God that you received, and also the time you received, you believed, that word is at work in you. It's doing something. It's changing you. Say, neighbor, tonight is another night. The Bible says the word that you received, you believed, because you believe that word will do something. Which means if you receive and you doubt, there will be no any result. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12.
For the word of God is living and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of soul and spirit, and joints and marrow, and is a discerner of thoughts and intents of the heart.
Amen. For the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, going even inside the bone marrow. Say, neighbor, receive the word of God.
Receive the word of God.
Verse 2. The same chapter, Hebrews chapter 4, verse 2.
For indeed, the gospel was preached to us as well as to them, but the word which they heard did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in those who heard it.
Amen. The Bible said the message they heard was of no value. Why? Because they did not combine it with faith. Am I communicating? They heard the message about healing, prosperity, deliverance. But it was of no value to them. Why? They did not combine it with faith. Saneba, tonight is another night. For you to see the results of what you are hearing, You need to combine the message with the faith. The Bible says it was of no value to them. Why? They failed to combine the message with the faith. There are many people who are hearing the message. For example, our papa is declaring, you are the head, not the tail. But you are remaining to be the tail. Why? What you hear, you don't combine with the faith so that you can be the head. He may say, receive your job. But what you hear, if you don't combine it with faith, the job cannot come. Say never, never, never. Tonight. Tonight. My story will change. My level of understanding the scripture will also change. Do you know, our Father is praying for us. For us to change from where we are to another level. Am I communicating? Say, neighbor. Tonight.
Tonight.
I'm moving from glory to glory.
I'm moving from glory to glory.
Do you believe? Do you believe?
Oh, yes.
Psalms 3, verse 8.
Psalms chapter 3 from verse 8. Salvation belongs to the Lord.
Yes.
Your blessing is upon the people.
NIV, can you open for me? NIV.
From the Lord comes deliverance. May your blessing be on your people.
Amen. From the Lord comes what? Can you speak? From the Lord comes what?
Deliverance.
Once deliverance has come, blessings will come. Am I communicating? Am I communicating? As you believe that deliverance comes from the Lord, as you believe that healing comes from the Lord, prosperity comes from the Lord, promotion comes from the Lord, tonight your story will change. Am I communicating? Deuteronomy chapter 1, that is gear 2 now. From verse 6. Deuteronomy chapter 1.
The Lord our God said to us at Horeb.
Yes.
You have stayed long enough at this mountain. Break camp and advance into the hill country of the Amorites. Go to all the neighboring peoples of Araba in the mountains, in the western foothills, in the Negev, and along the coast to the land of Canaanites and to Lebanon, as far as the river Euphrates.
Amen.
Amen.
You have stayed long enough at this mountain.
Oh, yes.
This is the Lord speaking. You have stayed long enough on this mountain. Say, neighbor, you have stayed long enough.
Stayed long enough.
On this level.
On this level. Level.
Are you ready to move tonight? The Bible says, break camp and advance.
Chateau.
You have stayed long enough on this mountain. Here now, the mountain stands for a problem. You have been there for so long. You don't move. There is a need for you to advance. Am I communicating? Say neighbor, neighbor, neighbor. Break camp.
Break camp.
Advance.
Advance.
Go forward.
Go forward.
Are you receiving your people?
I'm receiving, sir.
Can you see your, just check your situation, or maybe I can say your finances or whatever you are doing. You have stayed long enough at that level. You have been waiting, waiting, waiting since January up to now. I'm waiting for a miracle. You have stayed long enough. Time has come. Am I communicating? Time has come for you to advance, to go forward. Ay, 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 ay.
Neighbor,
time has come.
Time has come.
Advance.
Advance.
Go forward.
Go forward.
Say neighbor, neighbor, neighbor.
Neighbor.
You have stayed long enough on this mountain.
You have stayed long enough at this mountain.
Overflow, overflow, overflow. Are you there? Hodi, are you there? Hodi. I believe tonight somebody will move. You know, on one position at work, no promotion. It's an error. You are on a position, no promotion. But tonight, the grace that is upon my father, Major One, will change somebody's story.
I receive with faith.
Should I go now? Another gear now.
Yes.
Are you ready, you people?
Oh, yes.
Exodus chapter 10. Glory be to God. From verse 8.
Then Moses and Aaron were brought back to Pharaoh. Go worship the Lord your God, he said. But tell me who will be going.
Yes. Continue.
Moses answered, we will go with our young and our old, with our sons and daughters, and with our flocks and herds, because we are to celebrate a festival to the Lord. Then Pharaoh said, the Lord be with you. If I let you go along with your women and children, clearly you are bent on evil. No, have only the men go and worship the Lord, since that's what you have been asking for. Then Moses and Aaron were driven out of Pharaoh's presence. And the Lord said to Moses, stretch out your hand over Egypt.
Glory be to God. Amen. The Bible says on verse 8, Moses was asked by Pharaoh, who will now be going? Because you are saying that you should go. Say neighbor. Every spirit of Pharaoh.
Every spirit of Pharaoh.
Tonight.
Tonight.
Will be casted out.
Will be casted out.
You know, I will explain, and some of you, you will say, ah, that spirit of Pharaoh is working in my house. You will see, you will discover. When Moses was saying, we should go to Canaan, we should come out of Egypt, Pharaoh said, no, let only men go. Let children and women remain in Egypt. That spirit is still there today.
Come on.
Woman, that spirit may say, okay, let the man be serious in prayers, but the woman, the children, remain at home. Are they receiving a revelation there? The spirit of Pharaoh was saying only men should go. Let women remain in Egypt. Let the children remain in Egypt. That is the spirit of failure. Just fancy. Let us just imagine. Men have gone to Canaan, and women and children are in Egypt. Who will take care of the family? The spirit of separation. The spirit that is separating families. Then Moses said, no, we'll go with our children. Am I communicating? With our women and also flocks and their heads. We'll go. Pharaoh said, no, only men should go. Have you not seen that even in a house, we see that the wife is very serious in prayers. But the man, you know me, be praying, I cannot pray. Have you not seen that? The spirit of failure. Ask your neighbor, are you getting a revelation here? On verse 24, man of God, can you read the same chapter?
Verse 24. Then Pharaoh summoned Moses and said, go worship the Lord. Even your women and children may go with you. Only leave your flocks and herds behind.
Can you hear what Pharaoh is saying? After Moses confronted and the Lord intervened, Pharaoh said, okay, now let all women and children accompany you, but leave behind your flocks and herds. Leave behind your wealth in Egypt. Be a born again, be a believer, but let me take your wealth. The spirit of Pharaoh tonight will leave your heart. Am I communicating? And the Bible says, Moses said, no, we cannot leave the flocks behind because some of them will be using it to worship the Lord. It will be supporting our families, but the other will be also using it to worship the Lord. Say, neighbor, you are blessed. Tell your neighbor, you are blessed. Tell your neighbor, you are blessed. You know, there are a lot of challenges in finances or wealth. Why the spirit of failure is always fighting against believers. Okay, go to church, but I'll take hold of what is yours. But after tonight, something great will happen. Then Moses said, I will go. We'll go with our children and everything that belongs to us. Then Pharaoh said again, Exodus chapter 8, verse 28. He said, go, but don't go very far. He said, okay, but don't go very far. Some of you, the enemy spoke those words on you. You may start a business. He said, okay, start, but will not go very far. Some of you, you were very intelligent in school during the time you were at school, but you have not gone very far with your education because the enemy uttered a word on you. You will not go very far. But tonight, the story will change. Am I communicating? Pharaoh said, go, but don't go very far. Some of you said, no, now I'm on courtship. I am about to be married. Only 2 months. It is gone. Am I communicating? But tonight, somebody's soul will change. Do you believe you people? Say, neighbor, I'm going very far. Can you read, man of God? Can you read so that someone should pick a revelation?
Exodus 8:28. Pharaoh said, I will let you go to offer sacrifices to the Lord your God in the wilderness, but you must not go very far. Now pray for me.
You know, Pharaoh uttered a word. Don't go very far. Which means you can start something. You know, even other people you have heard that have ever said, I have studied this thing. You will not go very far. That is a case. But tonight, I declare, you go very far. In your career, in your education, I declare as a servant of God, you go very far.
I receive.
Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
I will go very far. Gear 3 now.
Oh, yes.
Are you ready now? According to your faith in the name of the Lord Jesus,
yes.
I declare as a servant of God,
I receive.
Whatever you're going to touch, you prosper.
I receive.
And with your plans, you're going very far.
I receive.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ,
I receive.
Say, neighbor, I'm going very far. Believe that you're going very far.
Oh yes.
Do you believe that you're going very far?
Oh yes.
Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
My children.
Who go very far.
You are prophesying now to our children now.
Oh yes.
Some of you, the enemy has tried to block you, putting the spirit of delay, hindering you. Putting you in Egypt. But tonight, I declare as a servant of God, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I declare the favor of the Lord shall attend you so that you can go very far in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, neighbor, I'm going very far.
I am going very far.
Do you believe this area? Whatever you are touching now, whatever you are planning now,
yes.
I declare as a servant of God, you are going very far. You are going very far. In your career, you are going very far. In Jesus' mighty name.
Thank you, Jesus.
No more spirit of failure. Nothing shall hold what belongs to you. Your children are being delivered.
Oh, yes.
Your family has been delivered.
Oh, yes.
In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I declare protection, whatever belongs to you. Overflow. Are you there? I declare as a servant of God, no spirit of failure shall hold your money. No spirit of failure shall hold your position. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Therefore, I declare promotion, prosperity, and multiplication upon whatever you have.
You are here to change our lives.
Yes, Lord.
You are here to move our lives.
Yes, Lord.
You
change our lives.
You are here, oh God.
You are here.
Move
God. Let's be kind for the Lord. The Bible says you have stayed long enough on this mountain. I declare tonight you need to advance as a servant of God. And the Bible says the favor of the Lord will change your start. Oh, yes. Oh yeah. You have stayed long enough on this mountain, on this problem. You have been complaining. Time has come. You are sorrow changed. You need to move. You need to advance in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Senema, I'm going very far.
Senema,
I'm going very far. The Bible says you have stayed long enough on this mountain. Many people that have been hearing about you, complaining. But tonight, the Lord will change your story.
Oh, yeah.
The Lord will touch your family, and your children will be delivered in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. No more spirit of limitation. No more spirit of limitation. I declare a promotion upon your life. You need to move from glory to glory, from one level to another, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Time has come for your story to change, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says those who believe in the Lord, they'll never be put to shame. They'll never be put to shame. As far as you believe in the Lord, there's a testimony for you. Because every test will turn into testimony. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I declare as a servant of God, under the anointing of Major One, tonight, your story will change. In the name of Jesus Christ. Senema, I'm going very far.
You know, there are celebrities here. I prophesy to your life. You'll go very far.
In the name of the Lord Jesus, the favor that is upon my father, Major One, I declare you'll go very far. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. With your business, you started it as a small, but I declare your business will not just be there, but will touch nations. I prophesy in the name of the Lord Jesus, your business will touch nations right away now, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. Your connections, I declare as a servant of God, your connections will not just be around South Africa, but I declare international connections in the name of the Lord Jesus. And wherever you go, there shall be favor. Say,
neighbor,
I'm going very far. Promotion in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
You have been waiting. When will my miracle now come to pass? But tonight, the miracle that you have been waiting, I declare as a servant of God, it will come to pass and manifest right away now, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Overflow, are you there? Overflow, are you there? Overflow. No more spirit of failure touching your children, touching your wife, touching your husband, touching your family, touching your property. I declare the fire of the Holy Ghost to bend every spirit of terror in the name of the Lord Jesus. Whatever belongs to you shall come to your hands in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Must come. Whatever belongs to you will not remain in Egypt. I declare in the name of the Lord Jesus, whatever belongs to you shall come to you in the name of the Lord Jesus. So
never,
I'm going very far. I prophesy, all children that are on education, I declare they'll go very far in the name of the Lord Jesus. Say,
never.
I'm going very far. Touch. Say, never. Spirit of
failure.
As I move to here, touch, receive the grace in the name of the Lord Jesus. I declare you are going very far in the name of the Lord Jesus. You are going very far in the name of the Lord Jesus. Touch in the name of the Lord Jesus. Whatever to touch with your hands, can you just raise your hands? Something great is happening to change your story, to change your story in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Right away now, I declare you are going very far.
See.
Touch. Receive your miracle now. Receive your miracle now. Receive your miracle now. Receive your miracle now. Receive your gifts. Receive. Pictures, the photos that you're having now, let them be touched by the blood of Jesus. So that they shall be deliverers in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So
neighbor,
I'm going very far.
I'm going very far.
Do you believe? Do you believe? You have stayed long enough on this mountain. Only one business, hand to mouth, no building your own house. Remaining a tenant, not a landlord. Time has come. Am I communicating?
Oh, yes.
Say never.
Neighbor.
Tell five people you have stayed long enough on this mountain, on this level. Tell five people.
Stay long enough.
Tell five people.
Stay long enough.
Tell five people.
Stay long enough.
Jesus. Say never, 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 never. Tonight, my story will change.
You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down.
Standing on the Father, Major One. Standing on the altar of my Father, Major One. I declare as a servant of God, in the name of the Lord Jesus, you are going very far and you will not be disappointed. The Lord is on your side and no one can be against you. In the name of the Lord Jesus, Senator, I'm going very far. Waiting for your job. I speak job upon your life in the name of the Lord Jesus. I speak promotion. I speak healing in the name of the Lord Jesus. I speak auto deliverance. Time must come. Your story must change. Time must come. Your story must change. You have to move from one level to another. I prophesy to your life in the name of the Lord Jesus. Move from one level to another. Your story will change. Your story will change. Receive the grace. Receive the anointing in the name of the Lord Jesus. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Touch, 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 touch in the name of the Lord Jesus. Touch in the name of the Lord Jesus. Touch, touch, touch. Thank you, Lord. Stayed long enough on one level. Greatness in you. There's greatness in you. Greatness in you. And I declare that greatness will come to all people. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Receive. 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 Anointing of my Father, Major One. Tonight is a night of miracles.
I receive.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Seneba, I'm going very far. My children are going very far. I declare right away now. Every spirit of failure, come out of your life. 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 In the name of Jesus. No more failure. No more failure. No more failure. No more failure. No more stagnation. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Touch. Touch. No more spirit of fellow hindering your marriage. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost bend every spirit of fellow in the name of the Lord Jesus. Touch, 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 touch
Receive the grace. Receive the grace. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I declare you go very far. In the name of the Lord Jesus, touch, touch, touch. Receive the grace, the favor of the Lord may allocate you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Raise your hands, raise your hands. I declare, as I'll just pass by here, the power of God, the anointing that is upon my father, major one, will change somebody's story. One, as I'm just moving here, your story will change. 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 Take it. Receive it. Receive. Yes. It is done. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Touch. 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 Receive your miracle.
I receive.
It is done.
Neighbor.
My story will change.
My story will change.
Tell five people. I'm going very far. I declare this to you here. Tonight, your sorrow changed completely. As I'm standing on the altar of my father, major one, your sorrow changed completely. Right away now. Receive the grace. Receive the grace. Receive the grace. Touch. Touch. In the mighty name of the Lord. Touch, touch, touch in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Touch, touch, touch in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Touch, touch. I pray for every document right away now. Receive the touch of God in the name of the Lord Jesus. Right away now. Take it, take it. Take it.
I receive.
Receive it. Receive the grace. Receive the grace. Receive the grace. Receive the grace. Touch. Your sorrow change. You go very far. You go very far. In the name of the Lord Jesus. No spirit of stagnation. Receive the miracle. Receive the miracle. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Touch it. Touch in the name of the Lord Jesus. Touch. 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 Touch in the name of the Lord Jesus.
place to change your story. Take it.
I am free. Take it.
Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. In the name of the Lord Jesus.
I am free.
Touch. Touch. The grace to change your story. Touch. 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 In the name of the Lord Jesus. Take it. Take it.
I receive.
Receive the grace to change your story. Touch. Take it. Take it. Take it.
I receive.
Take it.
I receive.
Take it.
I receive.
In the name of the Lord Jesus. Take it.
I receive.
Take.
I receive.
Receive your miracle.
I receive.
Receive your miracle.
I receive.
Now.
I receive.
Touch. 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 No more stagnation. No more limitations.
I receive.
Take it. You cannot just be serving the house of my Father. Your story will change. I pray for all ushers. Now, all ushers. Now, all ushers. Receive your miracle now.
I receive.
All ushers right away now. Make a line. You are serving in the house of my Father. Major one. Your soul must change.
I receive.
I'll just count 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up to 7. Miracles will start happening. Second, receive your miracle.
I receive.
Your soul will change completely. Your soul will change completely.
I receive.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
I receive.
As I counted 7 times upon your life, there shall be resurrection 7 times.
I receive.
The Bible says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Receive the joy of the Lord.
I receive.
Look at your neighbor, look at your neighbor. Just look at your neighbor, neighbor, neighbor. The joy of the Lord.
The joy of the Lord
is my strength.
Is my strength.
It is done.
My life is changing.
Jesus, Jesus.
To God. Say, neighbor, I will not remain the same. Neighbor, I will not remain. Do you believe? Do you believe? Say, neighbor, I will not remain the same. I'm going very far. I declare those who don't know you, they will know you. As you are connected to the anointing that is upon my father, promotion belongs to you. I declare in the name of Jesus. Those who are sick, wherever you are, receive the healing power now. Receive the healing power now. Receive the healing power now. Now, now, bring her here. Yes, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Receive the healing power now. In the name of the Lord Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus. I declare life, healing. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let the weak bones be strong. Light away now. Light away now. Light away now. Yes. Bring her here. Yes. Light away now. Just bring her here. Just in the name of the Lord Jesus. And free indeed. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Son of, yes, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Touch. In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Jesus.
Yes. Receive perfection. Jesus, stand. Stand up. Jesus, mighty name. Let the weak bones be strong. Jesus' name. Walk. Jesus mighty name. I declare, let the bones be strong. Jesus mighty name. Jesus mighty name. Right away now. Be perfected. Receive your healing. Now. Touch. Jesus mighty name. Strength come. Weakness go. Jesus mighty name. Go. Wait. Yes. Yes. Grace. 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 Touch. 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 Touch in the mighty name of Jesus. Perfection. Jesus, let the weak bones be strong now. Jesus' name, perfection, 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 with the blood of Jesus, perfection, with the blood of Jesus, light away now, perfection, with the blood of Jesus. Jesus' name, grace, touch here. Perfection. blood now. In the name of the Lord Jesus. 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 Jesus, let me pray. Ashes, oh ashes, hold it. Overflow, ashes. Come here. As I'm waiting for my brother, Evangelist Fritz, who take over.
Wonderful Jesus, wonderful Savior.
I'll also count seven. As you're serving in the house of my father, Major One, you are not supposed to remain the same. The Lord will change you. As you're serving in the house of my father, Major One, the Lord will change you. If you want marriage, you receive it. If you want job, we're going to receive it. Whatever you desire, I'll count seven times. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Touch.
I will worship
touch.
You. Wonderful.
Touch. Touch. I declare seven times restoration upon your life in the name of Jesus. It is done. I'm handing over to my brother, Evangelist Fritz.
Clap your hands for Jesus.
Touch.
Wonderful Savior.
Can we stand in the presence of God? Come on, just clap your hands for Jesus. I'm telling you, the grace of Major is flowing so strongly here tonight. And I don't want people to go home without a prophecy. Amen? Can I prophesy to someone? No, I mean, can I prophesy on another level to someone? Jesus. Put your hands together for Jesus. You are not staying in the same place tonight, amen. You are moving to the next level.
One, two.
Once again, clap your hands for Jesus. Now, I don't know. I just have maybe one or two prophecies. Can I prophesy to you tonight? Okay, just because you are so hungry, can we do three prophecies tonight? There's a lady in the overflow. Can I prophesy to the overflow first? Okay, the overflow is sleeping. Can I prophesy to someone in the overflow? There's a woman in the overflow. You are married and you have a daughter. She is about 12 years of age. Your husband's name is something like Kasin. Kasin. Can you come here? Come to me. Bring your husband with you. Run, woman, run. Someone is hijacking your prophecy. Can you sit down? Everybody sit down. Sit down. Say, son of Major One, prophesy to me. I'm waiting for that lady. Is she running? The prophetic grace is flowing so strongly tonight. nothing is hidden, anything can be revealed. Amen. Hallelujah. Woman, are you married to a man by the name of Kasim?
Yes.
Who is Lebo?
Lebo is my child.
Is your child?
Yes.
Just wait here. I hear something else. Can you just wait there? Sit down, everybody. I hear Christian. Christian. Are you Christian? Wait. Tonight I prophesy under the grace of my Father, Major One. Amen. Christian, you have a ministry?
Yes, sir. I receive. Prophesy.
Do you have a ministry, sir?
Yes, sir.
Come to the front quickly. Yeah! Quickly. You, sir, tonight God is changing your life.
Hey, I receive.
Can you stand up? Can you stand up? You don't bow to a small man like me.
Prophesy, prophesy.
The grace of my Father, Major One, is about to change your
I
life.
I receive.
Tonight. Can you receive on his behalf?
I receive. I receive, I receive, I receive.
I see a church. There's this church. There's this ministry.
Yes, sir.
You started this ministry.
Yes, man of God.
It is something city.
Yes, man of God.
City of God.
Yes, man of God.
Is the name of the ministry.
That is the name. That is the name.
But the ministry is
Correct.
Very small.
It's very small.
Listen, you started this ministry.
Yes, man of God.
Wait, we are going somewhere.
Prophesy.
Who is Tuli?
My wife.
Is your wife, right?
Yes, man. Prophesy.
This ministry is not going anywhere, right?
Yes, man of God.
It's very small. It's like 21 members.
Yes, man of God.
You know where the trouble started, right?
Tell me, man of God.
Somebody say prophesy.
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 This thing
prophesy.
Started. I'm about to prophesy.
Speak to me. Speak to me, man of God.
This thing started. You were on the trip to Nigeria, right?
Yes, man of God.
There was an accusation in Nigeria.
Yes, man of God.
What happened in Nigeria?
In Nigeria? Somebody committed a crime and I was walking by and
not a crime, robbery.
Yes,
robbery, armed robbery.
Armed robbery. And I was walking by and the police missed the man and then arrested me instead.
They so arrested you
instead.
They kept you only for one day, right?
Only for one day.
Uh-huh.
Only for one day. The angel of God appeared to me and said, by tomorrow morning you are out. And that tomorrow.
Wait. Who's prophesying now?
Oh, yeah. Hey, professor. Professor.
Here, Major, sir.
Woman, you've been praying for another child, eh?
Yes.
You have one child. She's 12 years old.
Yes, it's
you've
true.
You've been praying for another child, but you can't have another child.
Yes, that's true.
Is your husband here tonight?
Yes, I don't know. He's working somewhere. I don't know he's here.
Because you are here tonight.
Oh, yes.
Listen. You have some money. You're about to start a business, right?
Yes, yes, it's true. I must pay deposit tomorrow in the
Wait.
Shop.
Wait. What is the 7,000 rand I see?
It was some of the savings. I must pay the deposit with it.
Somebody say prophesy.
Prophesy.
Prophesy. Son of Major One.
Sir, wait here. I have very good news for you.
Go
right?
deeper, man
Don't
of God.
Go away.
Go deeper, man of God.
I'm hearing something on that side. Can you sit down? Sit down, clap your hands for Jesus. Yes. Clap your hands for Jesus. I hear Joanna. Joanna. Who is Joanna?
I'm Johanna.
Who is Elizabeth?
It's my mother.
It's your mother.
Yes.
Come, let me prophesy to you.
Yeah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Son of Major One.
Can you stand here? Stand, no, stand, Mama. The Bible is talking about the manifold grace of God. Amen.
Oh, yes.
Manifold grace means. You are Joanna?
I'm Joanna.
It's another Joanna.
Joanna, I'm Joanna. I'm
Joanna. Joanna.
Joanna.
Oh, wait. It's not you, sir. It's not you. I found the right Joanna. You may be seated. I found the lady I was looking for. Joanna, I'm coming to you. The God of my father, Major One, is about to change your story tonight.
Oh,
you will no longer cry. Amen.
Amen. I receive.
Who is Koketsu?
Oh, Koketsu is my second son.
Koketsu is your second son.
Ooh, yes.
Why you say, ooh, yes?
Oh.
In Nigeria, they would say, yes,
oh. Oh, yes, oh.
Wait. Can I change your story by the grace of my father?
Change my story. Change my story.
You have been praying. You said, God, if I can only meet Major One.
Yes, man of God.
You've been saying, listen, your miracle, do you know where your miracle lies? If you can submit your ministry under the grace of my father, Major One.
I submit, man of God. I submit now.
Can I shock you tonight?
Shock me, shock me.
You've
go deeper.
You've been praying for one thing.
Yes, man
you
of God.
You prayed and said, if only I can have the phone number of Major One.
Even today.
You prayed it today.
Yes.
Can I shock you?
Shock me, man of
After
God.
After service, I'm giving you the phone number of my father. Giving you after service, come to my office. I'm giving you my father's number.
I receive.
Giving you, you
I
want
receive.
Major's number? I can
receive.
Give you.
I receive.
No, don't come to my office after service. I'm giving you the number
I
to my
receive.
Father. The grace upon the life of
I
my
receive.
Father won't change
I
your
receive.
Life. Listen, I look at your marriage. It's truly right.
Yes, man of God.
There's nothing to speak about in the marriage.
Yes,
even
man.
Some months ago, you wanted to leave this woman.
Yes, man of God.
But because you are here tonight, there's restoration in the name
I
of
receive.
Jesus. Receive it, Jesus. You are jealous, eh? You are jealous.
Prophesy.
Woman.
Yes, man of God.
You want a child, right?
Yes, I do.
You have this... Lebo, 12
yes.
years old.
Yes.
But you've been praying for another child.
Yes, it's true.
Lift your hands. The grace of my father is available. In Jesus' name. Can I prophesy?
Yes.
A son or a daughter? Can I prophesy?
A boy, please.
Can I prophesy if he's going to be a son or a daughter? The question is not if you're going to have a baby. The question is now a son or a daughter. Can I prophesy?
Prophesy.
No, my father will prophesy that
no.
one. Go make a baby.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Clap your hands for Jesus.
Major son.
Mama, when I look at you, I just see pastors. I see children and I see pastors.
Amen.
What is amen? Can you confirm?
I'm confirming that my mother is a pastor.
Your mother is a pastor.
Yes.
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, yes.
But when I look at Elizabeth, somebody say in the realms of the spirit.
In the realms of the spirit.
When I look at Elizabeth, I see her taking tablets. Elizabeth has a problem of BP, right?
Yes.
Woman, can you answer as if you are serious?
Yes, yes, it's true.
You are shocked?
Yes, I'm sure.
Even me, I'm shocked.
Oh, yes.
I mean, a small boy like me prophesying deep things like this. I'm shocked. Clap your hands for the grace of our Father.
Oh, yes.
Your mother's got BP, right?
Yes.
Your mother's got arthritis in the bones, right? But because you are here tonight, I speak healing to your mom.
Oh,
in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
I receive.
By the grace of my Father, your mother is healed as I speak. Amen.
Amen.
Say, I receive it.
I receive it. I receive it.
You have children, right? I see even these children of yours. Pastor. You have children as pastors?
The younger one.
One is a pastor.
Yes.
Is this Koketsu?
Koketsu, yes.
Now, now I see this Koketsu. When I look at Koketsu, I see what's happening.
I'm not really sure about that.
You are not sure. But by the spirit of prophecy, I reveal this thing today.
Oh.
The devil is trying to steal your child away from ministry. But tonight, under the grace of my Father,
I separate
your child unto ministry.
Oh, thank
in the
you
name
Jesus.
Of Jesus,
thank
give me your hands.
Jesus.
In Jesus' name. Take it. Clap your hands for Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, I hear something in the back. Can I prophesy to you in the back?
Oh, yes. Major son.
They are not serious in the back. Can you stand to your feet quickly? Stand to your feet. Listen, what you have seen, what you have experienced tonight, it can never happen without the grace of God. Amen. It cannot happen without the Lord Jesus Christ. It can never happen without the Allos Parakletos. Amen. Can you say Allos Parakletos?
Kletos.
By the same grace that is bestowed upon my Father. The same grace that is flowing to the sons and the daughters of the major prophet. I speak a blessing upon your life. Amen.
See.
I say your life will never be the same again.
I receive.
You are going from one level to the next level. Say, I receive it.
I receive it.
Put up your right hand quickly. That hand shall be blessed. Whatever that hand touch shall be blessed.
I receive.
Wherever you point that finger, it shall be blessed.
I receive it.
Wherever you set your foot, it shall be blessed.
I receive it.
The words of your mouth, they shall be blessed.
I receive
your bank account shall be blessed.
I receive
your marriage is blessed.
I
your ministry
it.
Is blessed. Your whole life is blessed in the name
I
of Jesus. I want you to pray one prayer before we go home tonight. Listen, if you are watching us on Prophetic Channel, thank you for tuning in tonight. The grace is available. We want to meet you here again on Sunday. Come Sunday in great numbers. Receive mighty prophet. The grace of my Father is available to change your life. Amen.
Oh, yes.
If you are watching us on Prophetic Channel, thank you for tuning in. Remember, you got to stay connected to remain protected. Amen. Shalom. Clap your hands for Jesus.
Because you have friends that are hard to find, we help you keep in touch. Because